Class 12, today I am going to start Unit 4, Chapter 4, Straight Line in 3-Dimensional Space. Okay, in this chapter, you have 5 exercises in this chapter, and in the first exercise you have 6 properties. You can go to summarization and see that properties. I will write all this on the board and I am explaining you one by one, okay? So the first property is the vector equation of a line through a point with position vector A and parallel to B vector is R vector equals to A vector plus DB vector. Now in the question, if they will ask you find the vector equation of a line through a point with position vector A and passing and parallel to B vector, means that vector equation is parallel to B vector as well as it's through an of a line through a point with position vector is A vector. When position vector is given to you and parallel vector is given to you and they will ask you to find vector equation, at that time you will use this formula: A vector equals to A vector, R vector equals to A vector plus DB vector. A, B you will get from your question and T is real parallel. Okay, so this T will remain as it is. Now the second one is the Cartesian equation in parametric form. We have to find Cartesian equation in which form? In parametric form. It means that T will be present. Why? Because T is nothing but real parameter. If they will ask Cartesian equation in parametric form of a line passing through a point x1, y1, z1 and having direction ratios A, B, C are given by x equals to x1 plus tA, comma y equals to y1 plus tB, comma z equals to z1 plus tC. So two things are given to you. One, that passing through a point x1, y1, z1 and direction ratio A, B, C are given to you. And which equation they are telling you to find? Cartesian equation. In which form? In parametric form. At that time, what you will do? You will just put x1 value, y1 value and z1 value. You will put A value, B value and C value. So from where these two are given to me, suppose that I am writing x1 value 1, y1 value 2, z1 value 4. So I will put 1, 2 and 4 there. And if direction ratios are 2, 6, 9, I am just telling you one example, okay? So direction value is 2, 6, 9. Then in place of A I will put 2, in place of B I will put 6 and in place of C I will put 9. Now the third point, the Cartesian equation of line passing through the point x1, y1, z1 and having direction ratios A, B, C are x minus x1 by A, y minus y1 by B, z minus z1 by C. Now both are for Cartesian equation, but this formula we will use, when they will ask in a parametric form, okay, they will ask in a parametric form is they will ask in terms of t, okay. But if they will not ask in terms of t, they will only say that find the Cartesian equation. At that time, we will use x minus x1 by a equals to b minus y minus y1 by b equals to z minus z1 by c, where x1, y1, z1 are the point, one point given to you, and a, b, c are the direction ratios, okay. Now class 12, 3.4, the vector equation of a line through two points with position vectors A and B is R vector equals to A vector plus TB minus A vector, minus A vector. Now in the first one, we have seen that vector equation when A vector, position A vector is given to you and that vector is parallel to B vector, at that time equation was R vector equals to A vector plus TB vector. Now in this one, the vector equation of a line through the two points, how many points? Points, two points with position vectors A and B. In this one, there is no condition for parallel. Okay, parallel lines like this, no condition. When you have to find position vector equation and for two points, okay, and position vectors are A and B, at that time formula is R vector equals to A vector plus T in the bracket B vector minus A vector. Now point 5 is the Cartesian equation of a line passing through the point x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2 are given by x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 equals to y minus y1 by y2 minus y2 equals to z minus z1 by z2 minus z1. Now in this one you have to find Cartesian equation again, but in this time two points are given to you. Okay, two points are given to you. In the point 2, when they will ask Cartesian equation in form of parametric form, then you are using one formula. When they are asking Cartesian equation only, then you are using one formula. When they will ask Cartesian equation and two points are given to you, x1, y2, z1 and x2, y2, z2, at that time you will use this formula, x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 equals to y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equals to z minus z1 by z2 minus z1. Okay, now this one, the condition of 3 for 3, the condition for 3 points x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2 and x3, y3, z3 to be collinear. So what is the condition that 3 points, when 3 points are given and we have to say that whether they are collinear or not, at that time we can use this formula, x2 minus x1 by x3 minus x2 is equals to y3 minus y1 by y3 minus y2 is equals to z3 minus z1 by z3 minus z2, when 3 points are given to you and they will ask, prove that 3 points are collinear. At that time we will use this formula. Okay, complete this one. Now class 12, open your book, exercise 4A. Very short answer type question, question number 2. Okay, now in question number 2, it is written the Cartesian equation of the line of a line 2x minus 5 by 3 equals to 6 minus 3y by 2 equals to z plus 1 by 6. Find the direction ratio of the given line. So Cartesian equation already given to you, you have to find direction ratios of the given line. So first of all, question is 2x minus 5 by 3 equals to 6 minus 3y by 2 equals to z plus 1 by 6. Now we know that Cartesian equation is x minus x1 by a, y minus y1 by b equals to z minus z1 by c. So for and a, b, c are what? Direction ratios. Okay, so first of all, in this equation, this Cartesian equation, we have to change in this form. Now how will we change? See, with x we have nothing, with y we have nothing, with z we have nothing, but in this question with x we have 2, in y we have minus 3, but here we have positive y. Okay, minus sign is with x1, y1 and z1, and here with z we have nothing, so this one is only correct, otherwise we have to arrange this 2. So how we will arrange this 2? Listen here, to remove this 2 we have to divide 2x minus 5 by 2, and if you are dividing numerator you have to divide denominator also, so 3 by 2 it will become. Now same thing, first I am writing minus 3y, then I am writing plus 6, because in Cartesian equation we have y minus y1, not y1 minus y. Okay, so first I will write y term, then I will write a value. So I am writing minus 3y plus 6. Now to remove this 3, I have to divide with minus, okay, I have to divide with 3. Now one more thing I want to tell you, okay, first let me complete this one. Now in this one we have z plus 1 by 6. So plus, this plus is made up of 2 minus. So we can write like this, z minus and in bracket minus 1 by, to make it like this, z minus sign we have, then z1 value is minus 1. Okay, and no need to divide with any number. Now when you will divide, when you will separate this 2 with 2x by 2 and 5 by 2, you will get x minus 5 by 2, and 3 by 2 you will write as it is. Now when you will separate this 3 with 3y and 6, you will get y minus 2. Y minus 2 because I am taking minus here common, okay, and this one will remain as it is. Okay, now we have to remove this y, minus sign y, because with y we have no minus. minus sign, positive sign we have. How do we remove? We can take this minus sign here, okay? Or what we will do? We will multiply with one minus sign. If we will multiply with one minus sign, we have to multiply minus sign here also. This minus minus will become plus, and we will get one minus sign. Okay. Now after this, 3/2 I am getting, minus 2/3 and 6 I am getting value of a, b and c. But it is a ratio, you have to find in a whole number, not fraction. So what we will do here, we have 2 as a denominator, 3 as a denominator, and here 1 as a denominator. So you will take the LCM of 2, 3 and 1. How much you will get as a LCM? 6, because you know 2, 3, 1 LCM will be 2, 3 are 6 only. So you have to multiply with 6. Okay. Each and every term you have to multiply with 6. Okay. Now after multiplication, what you will get? 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. And this one will multiply only. So from here you will get x minus 5/2 by 3 threes are 9. And then y minus 2 by minus 2 into 2 minus 4 is equals to z minus minus 1 by 6 is the 36. If I am giving equation 1 this one, and I am giving this one equation 2, now you can compare xx, yy, zz. Minus 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 minus. X1 value is 5/2, y1 value is 2, and z1 value is minus 1. A value is 9, B value is minus 4, C value is 36. So you know that A, B, C are direction ratios. So what you will write here? Comparing equation 1 and 2. When you will compare, you can see A value you are getting 9, B value you are getting minus 4, and C value you are getting 36. So what you will write? Direction ratio is equal to how much? 9, -4, 36. So this one is your answer. Okay. So first you have to convert this given equation, Cartesian equation, in form of this Cartesian equation, where you will have nothing with x, y, z, and you have minus sign, and here you have x1, y1, z1 value. First I am doing that one, then I am finding a, b, c. Okay, complete this one. Now class 12, come to very short answer type question. Question number 3. Write the direction cosines of the line 6x minus 2 equals to 3y plus 1 equals to 2z minus 4. So we have to find direction cosine. In the last question we were finding direction ratio. Up to that point much we have to do, and we have to find after that direction cosine. Now how we will do? Question is 6x minus 2 equals to 3y plus 1 equals to 2z minus 4. Okay. Now what you have to do? You have to remove this 6, this y, 3 and this 2. Why? Because in formula of Cartesian equation, it is x minus x1 by a equals to y minus y1 by b equals to z minus z1 by c. With x, y, z, there is no coefficient present, so we have to remove that one. So with x we have 6, with y we have 3, and with z we have 2. So what we will do, we will divide 6x minus 2 by 6, 3y plus 1 by 3, 2z minus 4 by 2. Okay. Now when you will separate, you can see here it will come 6x by 6, so 6 will cancel, you will get only x. Here 2 by 6 means 2 by 6 you are getting here. When you will separate, you will get 3y by 3. So 3 will cancel and you will get only y. Okay. And here whenever you have positive sign, you have to break it into minus minus. Minus will write outside and 1 minus will write inside. So minus minus again it will become plus. And 1 by 3. You will separate this 3 with 3y also and with 1 also. So you will get 1 by 3. Same thing if you will separate this 2 with 2z and minus 4. Here you will write 2z by 2 and here you will write 4 by 2. So what will happen here? 2 will cancel, you will get only z, and 2 ones are 2 twos are. So you will get z minus 2. Okay. Okay. Now here when you are dividing with 6, you have to divide 6 this one also, because here we have 1, 1 and 1. In denominator we have 1, 1, 1. When you are dividing numerator by 6, 3 and 2, you have to divide denominator with 6, 3 and 2. So that is why I am writing 1 by 6, 1 by 3, 1 by 2. Okay. Now you know that this is the value of A, but you have to make it in a number, whole number. So how you will do? You will take the LCM of 6, 3, 2. LCM will be 6 only. So you will multiply that 6 with 1 by 6, with 1 by 3 and with 1 by 2. Whatever LCM will come, you will multiply that LCM with this one. Okay. Now here you will get X. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6. So X minus 1 by 3, then Y minus in bracket minus 1 by 3, here Z minus 2 by 3. 6 1s are 6 1s are. 6 1s are 6, 3 1s are 3, 2s are. And 2 1s are 2, 3s are. So you are getting here 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And you know that these are coming in which form? Cartesian equation form. And this is the value of A, B and C. So direction ratios you are getting 1, 2, 3, which are the value of A, B and C. Now you have to find direction cosine. In chapter 3, you have done when direction ratios are given to you, means A, B value are given to you and you have to find direction cosine. Then you will use direction cosine formula is plus minus A by D, comma plus minus B by D, comma plus minus C by D. If you don't know or you will forget all this thing, go to that chapter and revise summarization. You will understand why I am writing this one. Okay. Now D is equals to root over A square plus B square plus C square. So A value is 1, B value is 2 and C value is 3. So 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. 1 square will be 1, 2 square will be 4, 3 square will be 9. So 9 plus 1, 10 and 10 plus 4, 14. So root over 14. But direction cosine is plus minus A by D. A value is 1, so you will write 1 here, by root over 14. Then plus minus B value is 2, so you will write 2 by root over 14. Then this one C by D, plus minus C by D. So C value is 3 and D you are getting root 14. So this one is your answer. In the answer they are not writing plus minus sign, but you will write it because in the formula it is given to you. You go to chapter 3 and revise summarization, you will get this formula. Okay. Class 12, come to short answer. Question number 1 and read question carefully, because in this question it is given find the equation in vector form of a line which is parallel to the vector I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap and which passes through the point 1 comma minus 2 comma 5. Reduce it to a Cartesian form. So in this one you have to find vector form as well as Cartesian form and the find the equation and that equation, find the equation in vector form of a line which is parallel to the vector I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. You know that formula to find the vector equation is r cap equals to a cap plus 3 t b cap. T b vector, r vector equals to a vector plus t b vector, and here b vector is always parallel. Okay, go to point 1 and read that line that position vector is a and parallel vector is b. It means that first they have given b vector because it is written find the equation in form of vector in a line which is parallel to the vector I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. It means that b vector given I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap and which is passes through the point 1 comma minus 2 comma 5. So this is the point from which it is passing. Okay. So now when points are given to you, first you have to convert this point into vector form. How you will convert? You will convert like this. First write let b vector equals to I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap and a vector equals to, here we have 1, so we will write I cap minus 2 minus 2 j cap 5 plus 5 k cap. Understood up to here? So to convert point into vector form only you will write I, j, k and whatever coefficient you have or scalar component you have you will write that one. With I we have 1 only so no need to write. With j we have minus 2 you will write minus 2. With k we have 5 so plus 1. Understood this one? Now vector equation is r vector equals to a vector plus tb vector. So a vector is I cap minus 2 j cap plus 5 j cap plus t you will write and b vector is I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. First answer done. Now they are asking reduce it to the Cartesian equation form. Now how you will reduce this vector form into Cartesian form? Be careful when you are doing. First of all you will open the bracket. So I cap minus 2 j cap plus 5 k cap, then you have plus sign t into I cap t I cap plus minus minus t into 2 j cap minus 2 t j cap plus 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 t into 3 k cap 3 t k cap. After this what you will do, you will separate I cap j cap and k cap one. So I cap is this one I cap and one more is t I cap. So you will take common I cap only, and if you are taking common from here I cap only one will left plus t I cap. So from here also you are taking I common only plus t will left. So I am writing here 1 plus t within the bracket and I cap. Okay. Now with j cap you will take common. Now which one is common? You have to take only j cap common. So j cap common you are writing outside, and what is left here? Minus 2. Minus 2 and here minus 2t minus 2t. Please class 12 don't change the sign. You have to keep plus here. If you are getting minus, just put it inside the bracket. Okay. Now here 5t cap and here 3t k cap. So k cap will be common. Here plus 5 left and here plus 3t left. So you will write plus here 5 plus 3t. Understood? Now you are getting this one. It means that you know that if there is any equation, it will be in this form xi cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Any vector equation are in this form xi, x, y, z are scalar component and I vector, j vector and k, I cap, j cap and k cap are vectors component. So if you will compare this two, x value you are getting how much? 1 plus t. If you will compare this to y value you are getting minus 2 minus 2t, z value you are getting 5 plus 3t. That is why I am writing x equals to 1 plus t, y equals to minus 2 minus 2t, z equals to 5 plus 3t. Okay. Now from each one we will find the value of t. So if plus 1 will come this side it will become minus 1, so x minus 1 equals to t. Now minus 2 will come, it will become plus 2 and this minus 2 will come down as a denominator. Now plus 5 will come, it will become minus 5 and plus 3 will come as a denominator. So t value you are getting x minus 1, here t value you are getting y plus 2 by minus 2, here t value you are getting z minus 5 by 2. So Cartesian equation will be x minus 1, y plus 2 by minus 2, z minus 5 by equals to sign you will get between them. Okay, so this is the process to find vector equation, and from that vector equation you can find Cartesian equation. Please go through it properly and copy this one. Now class 12 short answer question number 3. In the question, please first read the question. It is given the Cartesian equation of a line is x plus 3 by 2 equals to y minus 5 by 4 equals to z plus 6 by 2. Find the vector equation for the line. Now Cartesian equation is given to you. Using that Cartesian equation you have to find vector form. Okay, so in this one when Cartesian is given to you and you have to find vector form, how you will do? Question is x plus 3 by 2, y minus 5 by 4 equals to z plus 6 by 2. What you will do? Let x plus 3 by 2, y minus 5 by 4 equals to z plus 6 by 2 equals to t. Okay, whenever Cartesian is given to you and they will ask vector form, you will use this one, this process. You will let that one. Now when you are letting, it means x plus 3 by 2 equals to t, y minus 5 5 by 4 equals to 3 and z plus 6 by 2 equals to 3. So if x plus 3 I am writing and this 2 I am taking with this, it will become x plus 3 equals to 2t. Now y minus 5 I am writing, 4 will come with 3, it will become 4t, and same z plus 6 I am writing and 2 will go with 3, it will become 2t. Now from each one first I will find x, y and z value. So what I will do, plus 3 I will take this side, it will become minus 3. Minus 5 I will take this side, it will become plus 5. Plus 6 I will take this side, it will become minus 6. X value is 2t minus 3, y value is 4t plus 5, z value is 2t minus 6. Now let r vector equals to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. This is the form of vector, okay? So I am writing this one. Okay, always whenever they will ask vector form, first using Cartesian find x, y, z value, and then you will let r vector equals to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Now x value is 2t minus 3, then y value is 4t plus 5, and z value is 2t minus 6. Okay, but in vector form, and we know that r vector equals to a vector plus p b vector, means all p terms will separate, we have to separate all p terms, and all the without p terms will keep here. So what I am doing, first I am opening this bracket, 2t into i, 2t I cap, 3 into I cap, minus 3 I cap, 4t into j cap, 4t j cap, 5 into j cap, 5 j cap, 2t into k cap, 2t k cap, minus 6 into k cap, minus 6 k cap. Now what I am doing, first without t1 I am writing, see this is without t, this one is without t and this one is without t. So minus 3 I am writing, then plus 5j I am writing, then minus 6k I am writing. Then we have plus sign, I have to give plus sign, and now we will see t term, which is 2ti, this one, then 4tj and then 2t k cap. Now t, we will take common, what is left? 2i cap, then 4j cap, then 2k cap. Okay, this one is left. Now it is coming in vector form, all p terms will separate and all without p terms will separate. So this is your answer. Okay, complete this one. Class 12, three short answer question number 6. It is given in the question that find the equation of the line which passes through 1, 2, minus 4 and 4, minus 5, 2, both in Cartesian and vector form. You have to find in Cartesian and vector form when two points are given to you. Now, two points are 1, 2, minus 4, 4, minus 5, 2. When two points are given to you at that time, if two points are given, then Cartesian equation will be x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 equals to y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equals to z minus z1 by z2 minus z1. Now x1 value is 1, y1 value is 2, z1 value is minus 4, x2 value is 4, y2 value is minus 5, z2 value is 2. So in place of x1 I am putting 1, in place of x2 4, x1 again 1, y I will write as it is, y1 value is 2, so I am writing 2, y2 value is minus 5 and y1 value is again 2, so minus sign is there, so I am putting minus sign. Now z I will write as it is, minus sign as it is, z1 value is minus 4, so minus 4 I am writing in the bracket, then z2 is 2, then minus sign and again z1 is minus 4. Now what will happen, x minus 1 as it is, I will write 4 minus 1, 3, y minus 2 minus 5 minus 2 will give us minus 7. This is minus sign, okay? Now z minus minus plus, so plus 4, 2 minus minus plus, so 4 plus 2, 6. This is the answer for Cartesian form when two points are given to you. Now we have to find vector form when two points are given to you. At that time, equation will be r vector equals to a vector plus p b vector minus a vector. If two points are given, then vector equation is this. Now a vector and b vector from where we will get? We will get a vector from here and b vector from here. Okay, because points are given, so you can write this one. A vector equals to 1 I cap plus 2 j cap minus 4 k cap. Same thing I have written, y cap plus 2j cap minus 4k cap. And from here you will write b vector, which is 4i cap minus 5j cap plus 2k cap. Same thing I have written, b vector equals to 4i cap minus 5j cap plus 2k cap. Now formalize a vector plus t, b vector minus a vector. So a vector is this, then plus sign, then t. B vector value is 4i minus 5j plus 2k, then you have minus sign, that is why I am writing within the bracket. B vector is I cap plus 2j cap minus 4k cap. When you will open the bracket, you will get 4i cap minus 5j cap plus 2k cap minus I cap minus 2j cap plus 4k cap. Now 4i cap minus I cap will give you 3i cap, minus 5j cap minus 2j cap will give you minus 7j cap, plus 2k cap plus 4k cap will give you 6k cap, and these all will remain as it is. So this is your vector form when two points are given to you. Okay. Class 12, see question number 9. Three vectors are given to you. They are asking that whether they are collinear or not. Now see, in this question, vectors are given to you. First of what I am doing, let A 4i cap plus 5k cap, B I cap plus j cap plus 3 cap, C minus 5i cap plus 3j cap minus k cap. Okay. After that, first I am finding AB vector and BC vector. So AB vector will be, you know that in chapter 1 and 2 you have done position of B vector minus position of A. So position of B is I vector plus j vector plus 3ak vector minus position of A is 4i plus 5k. So after solving you will get this. Now BC you will find, BC will be position of C minus position of B. So you will subtract this position of vector C, right? You will get minus 6i plus 2j minus 4k. You can take 2 as a common and you will see you will get the same thing, minus 3i plus j minus 2k. So what we will write, AB vector equals to 2 times of BC vector, and BC is common, therefore ABC are collinear. Okay. When vector form is given to you, you can use this one to show that whether ABC are collinear. Class 12, see question number 10. It is given, find the point on the line x plus 2 by 3 equals to y plus 1 by 2 equals to z minus 3 by 2 at a distance of 5 unit from the point 1 comma 3 comma 3. Okay, so first of all this one is given, what I am doing, I am letting t. Then after that what I will do, I will write x plus 2 equals to 3, will go this with t, it will come 3t. So from here I will get x value 3t minus 2y value 2t minus 1 and z value 2t plus 3. Now point P is given 1, 3, 3 and total distance is 5. Now you know in class 9 you have done root over, distance formula is root over x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. And distance already given. I am taking this one x2, this one y2 and this one z2. So x2 is this, x1 and y2 is this and z2 is this. And x1 is 1, y1 is 3 and z1 is 3. So root over, I am putting x2 first, y2, then z2, then x1, y1, z1. So now you can see this root will come this side, it will become square, means 5 square will give you 25. 3t minus 2 minus 1 minus 2, 2t minus 1 minus 3 minus 4, 2t plus 3 minus 3 will cancel out and only you will get 2t square. When you will open using formula of a minus b whole square, you will get this. When you will add and subtract, you will get this one. So after being either or, you will get t value 2 equals to 0 and t equals to 2. This one you know how to do, that is why I am not explaining. So after finding t value, you have to put that t value in x, y and z. When t equals to 0 at that time, when you are putting t value in x1, y1 and z1, you are getting minus 2, 1 and 3. This one already you know from where it is coming, from first line, first equation. Now when t equals to 2, again you will put t value and you will get 4, 3 and minus 7. So what you will write, 2 points you are getting, minus 2 comma minus 1 and 3, 4 comma 3 comma 7. So these are one is your answer. Class 12, your homework is exercise 4, a very short question. Question number 5, short answer type question. Question number 2, 5, 12, 1 and 2 both. And if you have any queries, you can ask me the given email ID and by tomorrow submit your homework. Okay? Thank you.